An event organized by the Bagisu tribe of eastern Uganda ended in arrests outside Kampala.
We are only fighting for our existence, for our heritage.
The Bagisu held the protest dance May 19th after Uganda's State Minister for Gender, Peace Mutuzo, proposed a ban on their traditional male circumcision ceremony, saying it is unsafe and promotes promiscuity.
I would wish to caution the people of Mbali to stop or reduce the dehumanizing habits of circumcision, which are invoking the spirit of sexual and sexuality at an early age. The Imbalu culture is really a backward one.
The Imbalu circumcision dance, commonly known as the Kadodi due to its unique sounding drum, is used by the Bagisu each even year from August to December to initiate boys into manhood.
We have the right to stand and defend or preserve our culture as Bamasaba. Bamasaba as Imbalu or circumcision, it did not begin in the 70s regime. It began a long time ago, even before colonialists came in this country.
Since 2010, the government and international partners have been promoting safe male circumcision in hospitals as a measure to prevent the spread of HIV, the virus that causes AIDS. Members of parliament from Bugisuland say it's important the rite take place in the community. They say proper safety precautions are taken.
Its major motive was an initiation to manhood. One would not be expected actually to participate in any meeting convened by elders unless you had had a qualification. That would be a benchmark of having qualified to sit among men. And one would not even marry, be allowed to marry, unless you have actually been ushered into manhood through this cultural initiation.
Uganda is home to 56 tribes, each trying to preserve its unique traditions. The Bagisu appear to have won this round. Tribal leaders and the government minister tell VOA they have resolved their differences through dialogue. Halima Athumani for VOA News, Kampala.